what's happening around the world, at ito ang kanyang sinabi. We are now standing in the face of the greatest historical confrontation humanity has gone through. I do not think that wide circles of the Christian community realize this fully. We are now facing a final confrontation between the church and the anti-church, of the gospel versus the anti-gospel. And we see that especially more and more as we go more into the 21st century. Kaya nga sabi ni ating Santo Papa, no, Pope Francis, he mentions this again. Because many times we forget that the number one enemy of the spiritual life is not the flesh or the world. As I mentioned before, it is always the devil. He is the instigator of all sin and evil. Kaya sabi ni Pope Francis, we must never forget that Christian life is a constant battle against evil. Just as Jesus during his life had to struggle against the devil and his many temptations, he came to defeat evil and defeat the prince of this world. So they are always connected. Evil and sin is always connected with the devil. And sabi ni Saint John of the Cross, it is the devil who is the one who instigates the flesh and the world. He is the power behind making use of the world and the flesh to destroy the plans of God. So the devil tempted Jesus many times, and Jesus experienced temptation and persecution throughout his lifetime. And therefore, as followers of the Lord, of nating kalimutan that we will also undergo this struggle. The sad thing is that many people do not know that when they chose to follow the Lord, they are already in the struggle. They are already in a war. But they do not realize that they are in a war. That's why nagtataka siguro sila kung bakit parang with all the good they are trying to do, there is so much parang blockages. Their plans, their spiritual, their growth in holiness, they are not able to reach their potential. Because they do not realize. Maybe they believe in the devil, but they do not have a practical knowledge of the devil. Baka theological lamang, hindi practical ang kanilang kaalaman. And because of that, they do not know how to counter the attacks of the evil one. And therefore, Pope Francis tells us, Jesus many times experienced temptation and experienced persecution. So Pope Francis is telling us that persecution is also a hallmark of the demonic. And he warned that whoever wants to follow the Lord must be aware of this reality. That is why St. John Paul II also tells us again, he reminds us, we must therefore be prepared to undergo great trials. This was in the 20th century, sinabi niya to. In a not too distant future, trials that will require us to be ready to give up even our lives, which we see happening today in the Middle East, and a total give of self to Christ and for Christ. And this is a challenge in the next sentence. Through your prayers and mine, it is possible to alleviate this tribulation, but it's no longer possible to avert it. That means it is coming. Okay? Kaya nga, we remember the words of of Jesus to St. Faustina, sabi niya, that from Poland will come the spark that will prepare for my second coming. At alam natin na it is, of course, St. John Paul II, and also the Feast of the Divine Mercy. So to prepare for his second coming. So we have to be prepared to be able to enter into this spiritual war, but we have to realize how do we enter this. Hindi pwede pa sa pumasok lang tayo, we have to understand what are we up against, and how do we respond to this, how do we come and enter into this battle so that we may win with the Lord. Kaya sabi rin ni Pope Francis, sinasabi niya, even Pope Benedict mentioned dati that the persecution in the church is caused by Satan. That's why in May 4, 2013, sabi nga ni Pope Francis, so many Christian communities are persecuted around the globe. More so now than in early times. Why? Because the spirit of the world hates. So that means that it is very, very clear that the spirit of the world, which is the devil, is behind the ongoing persecution. As we see in the book of Revelation. Alam natin, the book of Revelation does not merely foretell the future. It tries to unveil what is happening at the present moment in the church. So sabi ni Pope Francis, no? This was his first homily. I think this was during Easter Sunday, I'm not so sure anymore, no? Or Passion Sunday. Sabi niya, some of you might say, but Father, how old-fashioned you are to speak about the devil in the 21st century. But look out, because the devil is present, the devil is here, even in the 21st century. We must learn from the gospel how to fight against Satan. Okay, so in the ministry of exorcism, no, when I was given the faculty 12 years ago by Cardinal Sin, no, I thought that, because I'm a psychologist. No? I have a training in clinical psychology. That's the reason they asked me to enter the ministry. No? And I never thought that I would see so many cases of extraordinary demonic attack, whether it is infestation, in mga haunted houses, okay? Haunted convents, no? Haunted schools, okay? No? Nor did I expect to see so many cases of possession and lesser forms of possession or extraordinary demonic attack, which we call oppression and obsession. Kala kasi nila na if the devil attacks as extraordinary, kami nila, possession lamang. At yung the other thing that he can do is really temptation. We forget that the devil can do many things in between. Just like with Padre Pio was not possessed, but he was oppressed. Okay? Saint Teresa of Avila was not possessed, she was also oppressed. Okay? So the devil can attack us in lesser forms than possession. Okay? So nagulat na ako na with regards to possession, so many, dami-dami mga cases of possession na I was really shocked, no? Na napakarami, especially here in a Catholic country. And not only that, no? May mga religious, no, na we had to deal with, no? Just like 2 weeks ago, I had to pray over a superior, no? Who was having so many nightmares. And I prayed a Roman ritual. I prayed a Roman ritual over her. Nagwala, no? First time nangyari ko sa kanya, she did not realize that there were spirits pala attached to her. Nung bata pa siya, that were causing these problems, no? Hindi siya nakatulog, marami siyang mga obsessive thoughts. And she didn't expect that it was pala demonic. So when I prayed, I did a diagnostic exorcism tawag dyan, no? I prayed in Latin, okay? Biglang doon siya, wala siya, no? Nag-react siya. So, there are people who are walking possessed, right? Sabi nga ni Father Nani, no, isang exorcist sa room. Sabi niya, the group of 2,000 people, 2,000 people, 10 would be possessed, but they do not know it. Until an exorcist would pray an exorcism over the person. So if you are how many here? So maybe that lima sa inyo. Okay, matapag, right? So we forget, no, that there are, aside from possession, there are lesser forms of demonic attack which, okay, has to be dealt with. Okay? Kasi, many times we only focus, we only focus so much on possession, we don't know that. There are lesser forms, okay, which, knowing the way, how to use the weapons of spiritual warfare, magagamit natin yan to remove these kinds of oppression and obsession. Those are the two other types, right? So sabi ni, so I did not expect, no, that I would be dealing with a lot of possession, right? Yung 20% ng mga cases namin possess, no? 60% oppress, siguro mga 10% obsess, and then we deal, siguro sa, as far as I remember sa aming statistics, siguro mga 15% infestation. We don't deal so much infestation. Kasi usually the assignment, we tell the parish priest na you have spiritual authority dun sa lugar, we teach them how to do exorcism of a place, no? Okay, kung infested yung lugar. Okay? So usually, kasi wala na kaming, even though we are 5 exorcists in Manila, no, there are so many cases that at any given time, umabot kami ng almost 200. Right? Cases of hindi lang possession yan, no? Pati oppression, obsession, and infestation. So we don't, we try to focus only on yung talagang malala. So we must learn from the gospel help to fight against Satan. Kaya sabi ni Pope Emeritus Benedict, very clearly sabi niya to, the first task is we preach to give people the light of the word, the message of Jesus. Because the world is ruled by the powers of evil, this preaching is at the same time a struggle with those powers. That's why we have to understand that when we are sent by the Lord, the devil will automatically put us under his radar. Especially the more you do some things for the Lord, mas marami kang ginagawa, evangelization, the more you will see certain things about this crop up na hindi mo akalain sa magtataka ka kung saan ang galing, ang daming complications. Right? So, we have to understand that because nakikita ko yung mga patterns sa mga cases namin. How the devil can block especially spiritual programs. Unless we know how to destroy itong mga attacks, protect ourselves, and expel these spirits that are sent to harass, then mahirap. No? We will see that kahit napakaganda mga programa natin, parang yung mga tao walang effect sa kanila. No? Minimal effect. Grace cannot really enter. Kaya even in Rome, Italy, no? 2014, now this is according to CNA, Catholic News Agency, and EWTN. Okay? Catholic experts say a cult activity and the resulting need for exorcisms has already reached a critical level. Okay? The International Association of Exorcists, whose 250 exorcists are placed all over the world, have noticed an increase in demonic activity, irrespective of particular places or cultures. So it is truly becoming a pastoral emergency, and this is why we have the necessity to combat this situation. So last year, even the Pope had to formalize the International Association, okay, because he saw talaga the need, and the Vatican course on exorcism is ongoing. So even the United States, marami silang training programs for priests to how to exercise and also how to do kind of the exorcism, how to use prayers or minor exorcism and prayers of liberation. Okay, so I will just define it according to catechism and the exorcism. Okay, so this is just a general definition. This is not, this doesn't mean solemn exorcism na ginagawa na, what can we say, the bishop or an exorcist in the Catholic Church. So according to CCC 1673, exorcism is when the Church asks publicly and authoritatively in the name of Jesus Christ that a person or object be protected. So una for protection, okay, against the power of the evil one, and be withdrawn from his dominion. Okay? So it would be good to even pray prayers of liberation, okay, regularly over even children. May mga kaso kami, I remember we have cases of children, mga 3 years old na get possessed, okay, because of some occult activity that the parents have been doing. Okay, so may mga bata as young as 3 years old na they get oppressed and also possessed. Okay? So I didn't even, gulang din ako dyan, na pwede mapapala. Okay, mapossess yung isang maliit na bata kahit hindi siya nagkakasala. As we see the gospel that happened, diba? Jesus asked the father of the child who threw himself in the fire, who used to throw himself in the fire, yung kanyang anak, and the Lord asked him, when did this start? Since he was still a child, okay? So that can pala really happen. Another definition of exorcism is expulsion. Okay? Exorcism is directed at the expulsion of demons or the liberation from demonic possession through the spiritual authority which Jesus entrusted this church. So the ministry of exorcism, okay, generally speaking, is to protect and to expel. Why are there many Filipinos, maybe who we may say, get attacked or get possessed? Because this ministry, the prayers of liberation and exorcism prayers are not enforced. Madalang na lang. And therefore, many people are not protected. Nor kapag may mga pumasok sa kanilang buhay ng mga spirito, these spirits are remain there for a very, very long time. Okay? Marami sa mga kaso namin, na mga pinoses later on in life, kung bata pala sila, meron silang imaginary friend at duwende. Okay? So habang matanda sila, ang dami nila problema sa buhay, they become addicts, etc. Then they exorcise them, okay? The demons speak through the mouth and sasabihin na, kaibigan ko ito, pinili niya ako. This person has chosen me to be his friend. So I we tell the itong tao na to, you have to renounce that friendship with that galinde, or your imaginary friend mo yan. Okay? Because may karapatan siya sa buhay mo, and he's the one now causing all these spiritual problems. Okay? Once the person gives the go signal and the exercise yan, then hindi na bumabalik yan, then you see right away the spiritual fruits. No? Marami dyan, nawawala yung mga sakit nila, etc. Okay? Yung mga emotional problems, even some physical problems, no? Physical sicknesses. Ngayon, bakit ang napakarami mga dumadami parang mga demonyo ngayon, no? Sa ating mundo. Okay? Why are they becoming more and more unlike previous times? Okay? I think it has to do something with the church is putting being placed under a test. Okay? Yung sinasabing ni Pope Leo, the 13th, where he saw a vision, and that's why he made a prayer to St. Michael, itong pinakita sa kanya in the 19th century, okay, when he made a prayer to St. Michael, and also the Pope Leo, the 13th prayer of minor exorcism. Ito yung pinakita sa kanya ng Diyos. No? What a horrible picture I was permitted to see. He saw what was going to happen in the future, the misleading powers and the ravings of the devil against the church of all countries. Okay? So that means that, remember when Satan was thrown down from heaven, many demons were thrown sa? Saan? Impyerno, yung iba sa mundo. Yung mga dinapon sa impyerno, we call them demons. Those who were thrown to the earth, we call them unclean spirits. Okay? So kaya may patatay ba dyan? Okay? So the unclean spirits, actually, yan yung mga tinatawag ng mga ating manilunod mga kanto, elementals. Okay? And that has always been the teachings of the church fathers. The fairies, the dwarves, the elves, whatever, no? They call them fairies, the general term, or elementals, sabi nga ni Pope. And at St. Paul, no? The elemental spirits of the universe, these are the unclean spirits around us. So usually, yung mga Pilipino, because they have some experience with these spirits, halimbawa, especially yung psychic sila, sensitive sila, nakita sila ng mga tikbalong dyan, no? Or maybe isang kapre, whatever, no? Nag-aalay yan. Okay? So that is, of course, idolatry. Okay? And what happens there is that they form a bond with these unclean spirits. Okay? Itong mga, sabi ng mga church fathers, itong mga unclean spirits or fairies, yan yung mga naging Diyos-Diyos sa mga pagano. They became Arpaditos, they became the Baals in the Old Testament. Okay? They became the Egyptian, Greek, and Roman gods. Because men saw the power of these unclean spirits. Now, who are the more powerful spirits? Yung mga tinapon sa impyerno. And these spirits that tinapon sa impyerno, we call demons. Usually, they are called upon, they are conjured on this earth. Dumadating sila sa mundo through witches and satanists when they do their rituals. Gumagawa sila ng mga ritual, and who they call are not the unclean spirits around us, but the demons straight from here. Kaya malalakas sila. Okay? That's why they can do curses. Okay? Then they can do black magic, tawag dyan. Pwede sila mambara, mangkulang. Okay? Hindi ko niniwala sa bara, no? Until I saw for myself, na yun na nga, yung nabara, may mga insekto lumalabas sa kanyang katawan. Okay, o sumusuko siya ng mga pako and mga, what about this, iba-iba mga klase, no? Mga bato, whatever, no? And also once I saw, nung may lumabas sa kanyang dibdib na tornillo na malaki, no? Yung sa babae na nabara, okay? So that means this is black magic, okay? So these are spirits, they have more power because they call upon more powerful fallen angels. Di ba alam natin, there are nine fires? Okay? And usually, those in hell are yung mga fallen seraphs and those fallen cherubim. Okay? Usually, yung mga nandito sa lupa ang mga, what we say, the hierarchy from the angels and archangels. Diyan yung mga tinapon dito sa lupa. Okay? So, our guardian angels, saan sila kinukuha? From anong rangko, anong pangkat ng mga anghel? Di ba there are nine choirs? Pinamataas yun. Seraphim, cherubim. Seraphim, cherubim. Thrones. No, not principalities. Powers. Virtues. Ano pa? Dominions. Principalities. Yung third, that is already the third choir. Okay? Principalities are angels over countries. Okay? While Our angels, okay, are usually they are the messengers and they're also intervening between God and man. Okay, while angels, doon kinukuha yung mga guardian angels natin, okay? That's why usually yung mga elementals that we deal with, the unclean spirits are from the rank of the angels and archangels. Kaya hindi masyado malakas. Okay? Kaya halimbawa, yung isang bahay infested, usually may katabi silang isang balay, may balang dyan, kape, whatever, no? That is an unclean spirit, madaling tanggalin yan with a short minor exorcism or a prayer of liberation. And using sacramental, okay? Mas mahirap kapag yung sa isang lugar, may gumawa ng satanic ritual. Okay? Just like I mentioned last year, no, yung sa seminary, dalawa na possess ng seminarista kasi yung isa na practice satanism, no? He conjured demons from hell using a pentagram from his own blood. Okay? Kaya, lahat ng mga buong dorm, okay? Okay? Nang pag-umumot sila, ang dami nakita mga spirito, okay? It was harder to expel because it was conjured from hell. Okay? At nakita niya sa internet, no, how to conjure spirits. Kaya be very careful, especially mga kapataan, mga students, they have access to the internet. You can easily make a pact with Satan there, right? The internet. You can learn how to make a pact. You can also learn how to conjure spirits from hell to do your bidding, etc. Okay? And another, no? 19th century, the Blessed Aunt Catherine Emmerich, the greatest visionary of the church. Okay, I'm sure you remember her. Ano ba yung may palabas na galing sa kanyang visions? Yung Passion of the Christ. Okay? So sabi niya, in the center of hell, 18th century siya, I saw a dark and horrible looking abyss, and into this Lucifer was cast, after being first strongly secured with chains. God himself has decreed this. And I was likewise told that he will be unchained for a time 50 or 60 years before the year of Christ, the year 2000. Okay? That means, 1950s pa lang, he has been unchained 1,000 years. Okay? Remember the first, from the 5th century until almost, although pagsabi natin 1,000 years, say that it's chained, that's not really a definite time. Okay? But more or less, it's almost 10 centuries siya. So he has been let loose, okay, in the year 2000, kasi he's chained in hell, okay, but he has been let loose before the year 2000, and sabi niya, he said, Blessed Aunt Catherine Emmerich, a certain number of demons are to be let loose much earlier than Lucifer, in order to tempt men and to serve as instruments of divine vengeance. Okay? Because before the coming of the Antichrist, there will always be increased demonic activity all around the world. And finally, it will be the coming of Lucifer himself in the real form, which he called, of course, the Antichrist. Natatapon na ba kayo? We're going to the positive later on how do we defend ourselves. No? We're going to talk about some practical things. Right? So as Catholics, we do not believe in faith, bad luck, good luck, there is no such thing as karma, there is no such thing as chance or coincidence sa ating pananampalataya, nor destiny, since all that occurs is under the providence of God. Okay? So as God said to St. Catherine of Siena, no leaf of a tree falls to the ground without my providence. Okay? So therefore, when we look at the moral and spiritual chaos and destruction occurring in the world, which many times go beyond the capacity of human nature, men of faith can easily discern an active agent acting behind the scenes. With so much evil, persons of faith can never say that evil is simply the lack of what is good. They see a living entity behind it all. Okay? Now, it's very difficult to detect the devil because his number one strategy ay magtalo. Okay? That's why many people don't actually see him. Right? It's very hard to draw out the devil unless you know how to draw him out. Okay? And many times, sa mga tao, no, because usually when we pray to the Lord, we pray prayers of healing or blessing, etc. But we don't pray prayers of liberation. That's why yung mga demonyo na nakakapit sa buhay ng isang tahanan o isang tao, they remain unmolested. Because remember, if you want to expel spirits, ano dapat ang prayer natin? Deliverance or exorcism or prayers of liberation using the name of Jesus. Because that is the means Jesus has given us. But because napakaraming tao may alam nito, okay, they don't do these prayers of liberation or minor exorcisms or major exorcisms of exorcists. Kaya people can live with demonic spirit or demonic spirits attached to them. Okay? Remember, when we go to confession, the spirits attached to our soul, natatanggal yan. But not necessarily umapit sa ating katawan at nasa ating paligid. That's why many people who 10 years, masama ka nilang buhay, parang ngayon nagbagong buhay ako, parang ang daming pagsubok. We don't know that there are still spirits attached to him, and therefore that is where we use the sacramentals and the weapons, spiritual weapons natin. Because the sacramental, not only it brings about a more effective experience of the sacrament, but it also facilitates the effects of the sacrament. Yan yung bisa ng sacramental. It is always connected. Each sacramental is connected with a sacrament. Itong sacramental ng exorcism is connected with the sacrament of reconciliation. Okay? Reconciliation. That's why when we, after we go to confession, there seems to be harassments that the devil is trying to bring us back to our sin. Doon na papasok yung spiritual warfare. How do we use now the sacramentals? Sabi ni St. Paul, the weapons of light and the armor of light. Okay? That is what we call spiritual warfare. So, these are some of the signs. Okay? According to the church fathers and according to my own experience, 12 years in the ministry, ito yung mga napapansin ko that there is a demonic activity, and you have to use what we call these prayers of liberation, minor exorcisms, and sacramentals. Right? First, when in a certain place, parang dumadami, like in a school, dumadami mga attacks of possession, oppression. Oppression, pwede, ang dami nagkakasakit, pero wala namang, there is no diagnosis, okay? Or marami mga sa school niya, marami nagsisuicide, okay? Or maraming sa mga students yan, dami mga, okay, they have so many problems, okay? Obsession is, sa school, in a certain school, ang dami mga, okay? Obsessive yung mga bata, they hear a lot of, especially mga bata, mga psychic pa yan, no? They're more right brain than left brain, they hear a lot of maybe obsessive thoughts telling that they are worthless, they are, ano ba ko, na mag-suicide sila, o makapit sila ng tao, okay? So, that is obsession and infestation. Okay, in a certain place, there can be a sign of demonic activity if there are blocks to God's blessings, guidance, protection, and graces. Like a family who continues to pray, pero parang di na umaasin sa kanilang buhay. Maraming mga problema sa pamilya, right? And they didn't understand bakit ganito nangyayari. Okay? That's also a sign that there is something demonic already in na nakapasok sa tahanan na yan. There's outbreak of paranormal and psychic phenomena. Especially mga bata, marami na ako sa lugar, sa kanilang tahanan, sa kanilang bahay, okay, a lot of narinig nila na parang may naglalakad, wala naman doon, okay? So these are some examples. Sufferings that are not crosses anymore, they are burdensome. Okay? They make us miserable. Okay, so they are not life-giving. So napaka-miserable na yung mga tao na nakatira doon sa lugar. Temptations that are very strong and persistent, causing addictions. Father, bakit pag nandun ako sa bahay na yan, ang dami mo mga strong temptations. Okay? That is a sign that there is a demonic stronghold there. Valid and unrelenting harassments and blocks of spiritual life that lead to depression and suicide. Father, when I'm in that place, I always feel depressed. I always feel heavy. I always have these thoughts of suicide. Okay? Series of bad luck and freak accidents. Bakit pa siya yung pamilya namin? Puro nakakasakit. Puro parang na-accident. That's already... And if it is unusual, it goes behind the plan of God. Para why would God allow this? There's already demonic stronghold on. Or you have so many beautiful programs, spiritual programs, kundi parang wala ng mga effect. Okay? Very minimal effect. Okay? So all this we are seeing today, not only around the world, but also in our country. Okay? They can also affect nature. Diba sabi nga natin? Sabi ni author Heinrich Schiller, step by step, new destruction is wrought upon the condition of life, and cruel havoc is worked upon the earth, and among its inhabitants, by released demoniacal powers. Part of the nature of the demons is to influence nature so as to enhance their claims and authority over man. Okay? Di ba kumento ko sa inyo the last time that I gave a talk, yung sa Yolanda, di ba, yung isang exorcist doon na who prayed an exorcism prayer while there was the strong winds, etc. No, yung kanyang parokya lang, walang namatay, and it was left standing. So the bishop even asked him, what was his secret, right? And he said that when it started palang, because demons can aggravate nature, okay? Because especially sin can remove the protection of God, which gives the devil power, more and more power over nature. Because they have, all demons or spiritual beings have power over anything that is material. Okay? Okay, two reasons bakit palagi nagtatalo ang demonyo. We always try to remain hidden. It's his first tactic. So that a person either blames God for his sufferings, or if he is of little faith, he ceases to believe in a loving God. Kaya pag hindi na parang miserable yung buhay mo, and you don't see where it's coming from, who else will you blame except the Lord? Or if you, I don't think God is a loving God, or I don't believe in God because why is this happening to the world? Because tinatagal mo ang isang major player, yan yung demonyo. If you don't believe the devil, then of course, there will be problems in your theology. So a second reason is a person is better conquered when he does not know that he is under attack. Okay? So sabi ni St. Ignatius of Loyola, our enemy may also be compared in his manner of acting to a false lover. He seeks to remain hidden and does not want to be discovered. Okay? And Pope Francis, in this generation, like so many others, people have been led to believe that the devil is a myth, a figure, an idea, the idea of evil, but the devil exists and we must fight against it. So the Philippine context, right? So we now try to apply it in our own context, okay? So that we can use it for our own personal lives, especially as catechists and the educators of the young. First, ito yung nakita namin that the four major openings kaya na-attack ang isang tao sa what we may say, extraordinary demonic attacks. Okay? So these are the four major openings that we always mostly be present all together. Okay? First, of course, sin. Okay? We know that, that's very clear. Sin is so great an opening that even St. John tells us, he who commits sin is of the devil. Okay? Pangalawa, trauma. Most of our cases may traumatic experience. Okay? Because abuse attracts any kind of abuse on a person, whether sexual, physical, verbal, ipaulit-ulit na ginagawa can attract demonic spirits. Itong napansin namin. Okay? And not only that, they enter into the lives of tao. And if the person does not process it properly, walang nag-process sa kanya, they become deep emotional woundedness wherein doon kumakapit yung mga spirito. Because there will be hatred, fear, depression, and unforgiveness. Nakapansin namin na doon kumakapit, the spirits can enter through many doorways, but he remains there because usually there is deep emotional woundedness that a person is keeping within himself. Okay? He is filled with hatred, kapuotan, marami siyang deep fears, depression, and unforgiveness. Kaya kapag in-exercise namin isang tao, usually, it's only temporary kapag hindi na-address ang mga bakit yung woundedness ng tao. That's why usually they also have counselors. Okay? Once the person is healed and he is able to forgive, wala nang hatred, ang daling tanggalin ng mga spirito. Okay? Especially nakakalungkot na yun is, why are there so many young children getting possessed now? Okay? Precisely because, unlike before, the family was still intact. Okay, marami mga occult practices yung mga parents, but the children were still basically protected because emotionally they had a healthy emotional life. Yung kanyang relasyon sa ibang tao, this was normal. They had a Christian culture in the family to protect them. Kaya minimal, okay, lesser yung possession. And like ngayon, there's not only a lot of occult activity, there's a lot of sin, there's also a lot of trauma happening in families. No? Even in the seminary, no? Usually one-third ng mga bata na pumapasok ngayon ay may abuse. Okay? They were either sexually abused most of the time, okay? Or verbally, physically abused. Physical abuse. Okay? Kaya nagugulat rin ako. No? Sabi, I'm very shocked, no? That so many young people who are applying, no? I have been actually wounded, no? Deeply wounded. Okay, psychic abilities. Okay, this is another thing. No? Kasi marami ngayon, mga species sa New Age, right? Marami ngayon nagbubukas ang third eye because there is the wrong notion na kapag binuksan mo yung third eye mo, you will be able to have certain powers and to be able to communicate with certain spirits, etc. No? Kaya sabi nila, it's a gift. But it is not a gift. It has never been a gift in the eyes of the church. Kaya when you open your third eye, right, or psychic ability, tawag dyan, you make one becomes psychically vulnerable to the preternatural world. Right? I will discuss later on the three worlds, the natural, preternatural, supernatural. Right? As the Vatican document of the New Age, Jesus Christ, the bearer of the water of life, right, is a very good document of the New Age. Right? Dito nyo makikita anong mga New Age activities. Right? The point of New Age techniques is to reproduce mystical states at will. Right? Shortcuts to mystical prayers, supposedly. Like it were a matter of laboratory material. These practices all create an atmosphere of psychic weakness and vulnerability. Kaya lang, bakit 75% ng mga kaso namin mga babae? 76%. And 30, no? Plus will be our, yung mga lalaki, no? And we know this is because there's a tendency for women, no, to move from using intuition. There's an inline between intuition and psychic ability. Okay? Kami na they are still using intuition and actually they are already using psychic powers. Okay? Like for example, I can be, if I'm a bit intuitive, I can be seated, nakaupo ako, may nakatingin sa likod. Somebody's looking at me from my back, I can sense, parang may nakatingin sa akin, okay, that's intuition. But if for example, I start to use this intuition to try to read auras ng tao, or I try to read people, okay, and judge them according to me, ay, itong tao, ganito. Okay, I can sense who you are, okay, may mga tao ganyan. Then the person's really entering into the occult and psychic abilities. Okay? You're already starting to develop your psychic abilities. And therefore, the psychic ability is a doorway to the fallen angels. Right? I will show you later. Okay, there are three worlds. Alam natin, di ba? Sino nakatira sa natural world? Sa supernatural world? Directly to tayo. Supernatural world? Yes, God. And all the creation, all the creatures who are in the state of grace. The angels and the saints. Actually, also the poor souls in purgatory. Okay? They're really in the supernatural world. Who lives in the preternatural world? Those are the demons. So there are three worlds. The natural world where tayo, we are the world of matter. Okay? Preternatural world, which is a purely spiritual world, but is not in the state of grace, therefore it is not in the realm of the kingdom of God. And the supernatural world where the angels, the saints, and the Trinitarian God is. So tatlong world yan, okay? So the angels, the good angels, are not anymore in the preternatural world because they are now, okay, in grace. And therefore, nandun na sila sa supernatural world. The pure spirits who are not in grace, sila ang nasa preternatural world. Kaya kapag binuksan mo yung third eye mo, the farthest you can go is to enter and communicate with the preternatural world. Okay? If you practice an Eastern form of meditation, that's why even kahit hindi ka bininyagan, you can enter into, you can practice all these Eastern forms of meditation, and you can experience some form of oneness with the divinity, whatever. Okay? But as far as you can go, yung pinakamalayo na pwede mong marating is only the preternatural world, because to reach the supernatural world, you need grace. You need grace, prayer, faith. Okay? You cannot reach the supernatural world without grace. Kaya nga, maraming tao, sometimes, pinaghahalo nila, for example, sa prayer, sometimes they try to mix Eastern forms of prayer with our forms of prayer in our church. Doon nagkakaroon ng problema. Kasi yung mga tao, nangyayari, nagiging psychic sila. So nagiging open sila sa mga visions, mga revolutions, kanina na Diyos kausap nila, etc. Because Satori and Nirvana are mainly psychic, what we call psychic phenomena. They are altered states of consciousness. They are not an experience of God. Kaya no one, if you ask any person in other Eastern religions, how many God, who God is, they don't even know that there's only one God until now. Okay? They will only say that there are many gods. They believe in pantheism, everything is God, I am part of God, I don't need a savior because I am divine by nature, not by adoption. Right? So you can see automatically, kaya sabi ni St. Teresa of Avila, if you are really experiencing a mystical prayer, then you will know, you will have a deeper knowledge of the Trinitarian God. Kaya kapag if you practice oriental forms of meditation, you will only reach the a psychic trance state, an outer state of consciousness. It will not even give you a deeper knowledge of God. Okay? Kaya sabi nga natin, no Hindu or Buddhist will ever say that there is a unifying God or there is only one God. Okay? They are still polytheistic until now. Okay? So the preternatural world can only be reached by opening your psychic abilities. Because man is both matter and spirit. That's why he can enter into the world of the supernatural and also the preternatural. Kaya mag-ingat tayo, huwag natin akala na just because you develop your psychic abilities, you are communicating with the supernatural world. You will never see Jesus in the Blessed Sacrament, kahit ikaw pinaka-psychic dyan, nor will you see the guardian angel ng isang tao. Okay? So here also, if you are psychic, six na. Okay. If you are psychic, you become open also to occult activities. Occult attacks from occult practitioners because you are vulnerable psychically. Kaya may mga tao na very psychic, madali silang ilagay sa trance state or hypnotic trance. Yung mga butol-butol, for example, no? Isipin yung babae dyan, medyo psychic, no? Napapansin ng occult practitioner, this person, nakita niya, psychic itong tao, bukas yung kanyang third eye. With one look, I can put you into a trance state, hypnotic state. Later on, you are ready withdrawing money from the ATM, okay? Para you're hypnotized, okay? That's why being psychic is dangerous. So this is the fourth opening, occultism. One can be contaminated by occultism and therefore become open to demonic disturbances in three ways. By their involvement in occult practices, like practicing occult activities, going to occult practitioners. Sino ba mga occult practitioners na ito? Ito mga tao na who try to get spiritual powers but not from the kingdom of God. They have been there since time immemorial, even before the coming of Jesus Christ. If you are targeted by an occult practitioner, like a witch, through a curse, through, for example, a potion or curse, okay? Nagayuma kayo, no? So, sabi mo nga dati, mag-ingat kayo sa mga chocolate cake, no? Kasi meron akong isang, one of my first cases ni Madre, no? Na possessed dahil pinakain sa kanya ng isang naniligaw sa kanya, no? Ng chocolate cake, okay? Sabi ko, eh. Kaya pag pinag-pray over ko siya, no? Lumalating talaga yung chan niya, no? Tapos talagang may lumalating sa and brother, there was even a parang lilubid ng malo sa bibig niya, no? Kinain mo, sister, no? So be careful, no? So, because there is such a thing as, okay, kayuma, yeah. That has been known in witchcraft since the time of the early church, even the time of Christ, right? Okay? These are part of the powers of witchcraft. Okay? Or an ancestor who was an occult practitioner. Kaya, if you go to any of these occult practitioners, there will be some form of contamination. Right? They use spiritual power, but not from the supernatural source. If you gain spiritual power, it only comes from two sources. Kingdom of God, kingdom of the evil one. Right? There is no third kingdom. So therefore, if you get spiritual power, not using the means given to us by Christ, you're getting to the other side. Kaya nga, they are banned in the Old Testament. Okay? So if you have any contamination with these occult practitioners, okay, good to pray some prayers of renouncement and also prayers of liberation. Agulayo. Mangpukulang. Okay? Mangpabarang. Okay? Mangtatawas. One is engaged in pagtatawas. Right? It is a ritual where an affliction or psychological disorder is diagnosed by interpreting the form produced in a basin of water. Right? Manghihilo. Yes. Kasi pag may bulong yan, they are calling upon the powers in the preternatural incantation yung tawag naman ito. Okay, they are not, when they do incantations, they are not praying to God the Father. They're praying that usually they get their powers from mga duwende na very sensitive sila, punta silang guba, may nakikita sila dyan, na duwende, bibigyan sila ng power, etc. No? Usually may parang maitim na botol na tatanggapin nila. No? Sinasaniban, okay? Filipino practitioner who becomes a medium. Mediumship is demonic. Kaya yung mga sinasaniban ng Santo Niño o ng mahal na bilhin are demonic. Yes, there is no such thing as, okay, possession. God never possesses, or any divine being possesses anyone. Okay, He always makes sure, okay, that the bodily integrity, the will, and the intellect of the person is always operative. He does not replace the consciousness ng tao para magsalita bigla sa tao. Okay, nor do automatic writing. Even the Bible was not written through automatic writing. The persons were totally conscious of what they were writing. Okay? Kaya natin mga sinasaliman, these are actually possessed. They are possessed and they have made, they just don't know, okay, they, that they are possessed by an evil spirit. Kaya kapag over mo yan, itong mga mediums na yan, okay, you will, they will react violently. Mga hula, okay? Okay. That's why ito, ano? Okay. Deuteronomy verses verse 18, verses 9 to 12, when you come into the land the Lord your God is giving you, you must learn not to imitate these practices, okay, so practices of these nations. Okay, one who makes a son or daughter pass through fire, yan yung mga inaaling na mga anak sa mga bahalos, okay, they offer their children like